This is your one and only Firespark 81 with your daily dose of video goodness, and welcome back to another informative Starbound mod spotlight. Today, we are taking a look at Flask's design utilities, and it's all the stuff you see up here. So let's get to it and how you find everything. All right, so you're going to go into your workbench. You just need the base workbench here, and to get the blocks, you are going to type in PAL. Okay, and then here are the three different types of blocks. They're going to cost you 5 woven fabric a piece. They have the dark, the light, and the normal. Okay, and then we go over to the lights here, and you're going to type invis or INVI, and you got each of the invisible lights here. I don't know why they're called invisible lights. They're not really invisible. They're little 1 pixels. Technically, they're not 1 pixels, but they're tiny. You get the idea. Okay, and then we're going to go over to the bed here, and you're going to type in PHO, and that's going to get you the photo bed. Oh, the lights. I forgot to tell you the lights here. The lights are going to cost you 1 pixel each. Okay, maybe that's why they're called pixel lights. Okay, so anyway, the photo bed is going to cost you 1 pixel and 10 woven fabric. And then there is the photo chair, which is going to cost you 1 pixel. Okay, once you have all of those things, you ask, what do you do with them? Yeah, this is what you do with them right here. So, okay, let's take a look at the bed and the chair. So we have the bed, that's what it does. So if you're over top of this and you've created a green screen, you can pose yourself like you're laying down and you can cut yourself out relatively easy. And same thing with the chair. I assume that's what they're for. It seems legit to me. So that's what we're saying they're for. Then we have all of the different blocks here. Now, this is the normal that you see right here from this red stripe over to all this green here. I love that you can create a green screen with this. How great is that? Look at it, it's so good that you can just create a green screen and make yourself super easy to cut out for whatever reason you would want to do that. Thumbnails, it's great for thumbnails, I'll tell you that right now. Then we have the light, which the light goes from this white bar here to this black bar here. So this is all the light blocks, and they've been painted, each of the colors. I'll show you what they look like without being painted in just a second. So this is what they look like when they've been painted with each of the colors. That's what they look like on them. And then we have the dark ones right here. So from this black one over to this white one is all the dark, palette blocks that have been painted striped with each color. I'll get it out eventually. Just work with me here. Then we have the little pixel lights up here. That's what they look like. And they are putting off some light. You can't really tell here, but I'll show you in a minute. If I take off my EPP, and you can see there's a little bit of light there. It's not... Yeah, it's just kind of hard to tell. Anyway, so what do these look like? We have a bunch of them right here, and I can show you as soon as I get to the right thing. Okay, so we have the dark ones right here. That's chunk of the dark, chunk of the light, and a chunk of the normal. That's it. That's what they look like. It's relatively plain and boring the way it looks there. But the cool thing about it is that you can paint them and they're really, really bright colored, as you see there with all the stripes. They look fantastic. So this is great for all you pixel art people out there. And you can make some really gorgeous pixel art with these. Considering you have like a full range of palette here, yeah, you can do some really great stuff. Or like I said, you can create backgrounds to cut out scenes. You could create a whole amazing scene in the foreground here, right? And then use this green screen as your background and then just cut it out with like the click of a button in whatever your photo editing software of your choice is these days. They all pretty much do it. It'd be fantastic. Okay, so let's go over here and take a look at these blocks because I have a setup down yonder here to show you the pixel lights. So I put off a little tiny bit of light, but it's nothing serious. So we're going to take a look at each of these little pixel lights. So we have the white one, and it's pretty bright. It's pretty bright for a single little tiny pixel light. I think it's cool. I like it. There's a lot of stuff you could do with that. We'll pick that up. We'll do the red one. Now the red one is green, okay? I'm going to point that out. The red one is greenish color. So we take that off because they are colored lights, and the green one is red. They're backwards. So keep that in mind, that they're backwards. mod creator, they're backwards. Okay, so you can see that it'll put off about the same light, but when it's tinted, it's not quite as bright as the white one. And then we have the blue one. Blue one's pretty bright. I like the color the blue puts off. I like that. Some good lighting. And then last but not least, the black light puts off a nice dark red glow. And that's it. That is all there is to this mod. It's a really short, simple, little sweet mod. I love these simple mods like this that just add stuff that it's needed in the game. Because I'm sure there is at least 10 people that are going to watch this video that go, oh my god, I've needed a green screen forever, or a blue screen. Seriously, I know there's at least 10 of you, probably more. So, all right, that's going to wrap it up for this episode. Before I go, I just want to give a quick shout out to my Patreon supporters. Thank you so much for all of your support. I really mean it. You have no idea how much you really help out this channel. If you would like to help support this channel through Patreon, please check out the link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment down below and let me know what you thought. If you're shy, you don't like to comment, just hit that thumbs up button and show your support. Until next time, thanks for watching.